One of the definitive hallmarks of Cornell Engineering is the experience of a true university education. So what does that mean? What is a university education? Great question. It means our engineering program is embedded within a broader university structure. It is one of several colleges and schools that comprise the university as a whole. There are 100 different fields of study and about 80 majors running the intellectual gamut from linguistics to plant sciences, and include, of course, the 14 engineering majors that have their home in the engineering college. When you're thinking about our program in contrast to, say, an institute model like RPI, Caltech, Georgia Tech, the university model offers just incredible breadth of academic opportunity and intellectual cross-fertilization. For example, right now we have an electrical and computer engineering undergraduate student who is working with a graduate archaeologist to build a 3D model of a mummified bird and pioneer low-cost artifact digitization. So he's doing this as an undergraduate. The university model is just an expansive and compelling academic setup. Cornell is the largest of the Ivy League schools, and we are the only Ivy League institution that has a College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. It's a land-grant college for the state of New York. So from a practical standpoint, that means we encompass both the liberal arts tradition, the academies of arts, sciences, and humanities, as well as the Big Ten type schools, the research-driven universities with a real practical focus. Cornell really arches across both of those. There are 6,000 courses offered at Cornell each year, 4,000 at the undergraduate level, and 2,000 at the graduate level. So a good way to understand what this means is to think about your own high school experience and the number of classes that are available to you in any given subject. That might be 2 or 3 classes max that are real options for you at a given time. So I think that immediately gives you a sense of what 6,000 course offerings mean. The intellectual scale present at Cornell is just astounding. This means our engineers have the opportunity to take what they're interested in, science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and enrich those core interests with all types of different studies that exist across the university. When we talk about breadth, what this really means is that you can study almost anything that you can think of. It's a remarkable opportunity to take your interests and push them in different ways and directions. There are 122 minors across the university. You can pursue any of these while you're getting your engineering degree. I know a recent graduate who studied mechanical engineering and is now building fiber optic networks for the Chicago public school system. And while he was at Cornell Engineering, he minored in Viking studies just because he found it interesting. As well, you will be studying with, rooming with, dining with students who have different academic passions than you, not to mention different life backgrounds than you. That kind of interchange and interaction will broaden you in ways that you cannot imagine. It's just transformational. Another way to understand Cornell is to think of us in terms of our largest college, the College of Arts and Sciences, which is the beating heart of the university. Think philosophy, history, critical thought, the pure sciences, art, literature, ethnic studies. And surrounding the arts and sciences are the other colleges and schools, including engineering, which are essentially professional or pre-professional academic programs. So Cornell has this classical liberal arts center surrounded by a real devotion to pragmatic problem solving. And if you understand this, you will begin to appreciate just how powerful the educational experience can be at a place like Cornell.